the sound, vocabulary that astounds. From the planet lexicon, watch her villains, here she comes. Faced with a catastrophe, we need the living dictionary. Her superior intellect keeps the crime world in check. Go girl! Huggy faces by her side, vocabulary a mile wide. She'll make sure that crime will pay, then throw some mighty words your way. Word up, it's Word Girl. Word up! From the planet lexicon, what a villain. Here she comes!
Word Girl!
Hey kids, today's featured words are occasion and glimpse.
Today is the Botsford's wedding anniversary, and to celebrate this special occasion, Mr. and Mrs. Botsford are going out for some ice cream without the kids. Hey, who's babysitting?
I am.
Really? Wow, this is big.
You know, I have done one or two things that could be considered bigger.
Maybe we should wait another year before leaving our babies alone.
Mom, we're not babies.
Kidding, Mom. We'll be fine.
Plus, we're only going to be gone for 30 minutes.
And the neighbors said they'd come right over if we need anything.
I have the phone number of the ice cream shop right here.
But...
Mom, if you keep worrying, you won't be able to enjoy this special occasion.
Becky's right. What's occasion mean?
An occasion is something that's a happening or an event. For example, an event like a wedding anniversary is a special occasion because it only happens once a year.
Becky's right. You don't have an 11th wedding anniversary every day. So let's go out, forget our worries, and celebrate Botsford style for half an hour!
You're right. Bye-bye, worries! Hello, ice cream, right? We're off! Two toodles! Toodles!
Happy anniversary! Yes, Mom, we're still doing fine.
Later, at the ice cream shop...
Sally Botsford, in honor of this special occasion, I have prepared a speech that compares our love to various delicious ice cream treats. Okay. My dear wife, our first year together was like rainbow sherbet. Tangy and rainbowy.
TJ loves rainbow sherbet. Oh. Do you think they're okay?
Huh? Oh, I'm giving an ice cream-themed anniversary speech here.
I know. I just feel so strange to be on a date without... the kids.
But honey, if the kids were with us, it wouldn't really be a date. It would be a Botsford Family Fun Adventure Day. Today is about two things, ice cream and us.
Oh.
Meanwhile, on the dangerous side of the ice cream shop, the Whammer has caught a glimpse of something he likes.
Oh yeah, what's that?
Oh, that particular menu item is called the Ark.
The Wham?
No, the Ark.
Right. That's what I said!
If you say so, sir. Here the customer is king. Ahem. The Ark. Two scoops of every flavor of ice cream in the store, covered with a bucket of hot fudge, covered with a bucket of cold fudge, and a barrel of strawberry sauce, flanked by two giant bananas. Then it is garnished with enough nuts to last a village of squirrels all winter. The finishing touch is a mountain of whipped cream, so high you'll need a ladder to reach the top. Is that what you want?
Yeah! Bring it, Wham!
Oh, I'm afraid I can't bring it, Wham, sir. It seems that we just ran out of certain ingredients.
What?
Those two guests got the last scoops of rainbow sherbet and licorice ice cream. You can't have an Ark without those two ice creams.
Well, give the Whammer their ice cream, yeah?
I'm afraid I can't do that, sir. As I said, here the customer is king, and they're customers, too. Maybe I can interest you in a different sundae.
No! The Whammer wants the Ark!
Our second year of marriage was like a rocky road, but let's not go there. Hey, how do we get over here?
Oh, yeah! I'll take these. Thank you very Wham. Here you go. Now you can make me an Ark Wham, yeah?
Frozen fiddlesticks. That's our ice cream.
Yeah, what gives you the right to take our ice cream?
I need it so they can make me that. Yeah.
You won't get away with this. Not on our wedding anniversary. Dun, dun, dun. Did I just say that out loud? I was hoping the music would do that.
Back at the Botsford house, Becky is going over some rules with TJ.
Okay, TJ. Now, the most important thing is that we communicate with each other. Do you know what TJ?
Yeah!
TJ?
Yeah!
Okay, everything looks fine here.
Girl,
I guess we'll just check back in with TJ in a little while.
Listen, Wemmer, you untie us and give us back our ice cream right now.
No, Wemmer!
Uh-oh, there's trouble at the ice cream shop. Come on, Bob, work! Yo, that's right. We have to watch TJ.
Uh-oh, looks like trouble down there.
Oh, TJ, thanks for helping me save the day.
Oh, you're welcome, Word Girl.
Word up!
That gives me an idea. Since we can't leave TJ alone, this is one occasion where we'll just have to bring him with us.
Oh, hi, Word Girl.
Word Girl, is that really you? Wow, I'm your biggest fan. I'm even president of your fan club. Will you sign my autographed picture of you? That way I have proof that I met you twice.
Okay, I'll autograph the autographed picture. But I need you to do something for me, too. Will you come to the ice cream shop and help me stop a villain who's ruining our parents, your parents is what I meant, your parents' special occasion?
Oh, there's just one little problem. I have to ask my sister slash babysitter for permission first. She's in charge of me, but only for the next 25 minutes.
Did you hear that? TJ can be such a good brother sometimes. I mean, he... That's right.
Hey, Becky, you probably won't believe me. Word Girl needs my help. Can I go with her to battle a villain real quick?
Yeah, sure.
Great. She doesn't believe... You believe me?
Yes, I caught a glimpse of her coming in. And since Word Girl is a superhero and a very responsible one at that, this is one occasion where I will allow it.
Yes!
So, what did your awesome babysitter say?
Let me put it this way. Word up!
I say that.
Oh, yeah, right.
Word up! Remember, when we get to the ice cream shop, you can't let mom and... I mean, you can't let your mom and dad see you, okay?
Got it, Word Girl! Whoa!
Back at the ice cream shop.
I know a certain villain who's gonna get a tummy ache.
Well, no reason we should let a Sunday stealer ruin our wedding anniversary. You ready to hear my speech?
This is as good an occasion as any.
My dear wife.
Oi! It's your wedding, Whamiversity!
Yes.
Can you look on our faces?
Is it written on my face? Wedding anniversary? Happy guy? Great marriage?
Oh, yeah! Do you have any kids, Wham?
Oh, I miss the kids so much. I just need a glimpse of them. Then I'll be fine. Oh, they grow up so fast.
Honey, I know you miss the kids, but if I can just get my speech out and give you my gift...
Hey! Word Girl! What are you doing here?
I'm here to make sure everyone gets their fair share of ice cream. And I'm also here to make sure that no one's special occasion is ruined by your whamming.
You mean like this? Oh! Uh-oh! The whammer better hurry up and eat his arc. Later! Bring me my ice cream!
It's so cool!
Whoa! Stay down!
TJ! I just caught a glimpse of TJ!
Honey, really, TJ is home with Becky. What do you mean you caught a glimpse of him?
Yeah! What's a glimpse anyway?
A glimpse is a quick look or peek at something. But of course we know TJ is home with his sister, and how could you catch a glimpse of someone who is not even here? No glimpse, not possible. Oh, good glimpsing.
Word Girl is right, honey. You probably just miss those two kids so much that you thought you had a glimpse of TJ. Wait a second, Word Girl. How did you know TJ was at home?
Super hearing. I overheard you with my super hearing. Yeah, super...
Oh, now, honey, just let me finish my speech and give you your anniversary gift so we'll be ready to get back home.
Hey, can I watch?
I guess so, but shouldn't you be defeating the Whammer?
Oh, yeah. Excuse me. Okay, Whammer, time for you to hit the rocky road.
I don't get it.
Never mind. Such a waste.
Oh, yeah!
Hello, I am your waiter. Who ordered the Ark?
Right over here, William.
I got the coldest ice cream in the whole ice cream shop. Wait until you see what happens when he eats it.
Yeah, that ice cream is so cold. I love it. Yeah.
Honey, I miss the kids so much that now I'm imagining the waiter looks like TJ.
Me too. I wish we were untied.
Me too.
Oh, man, the Whammer's head hurts. When will this terrible headache go away?
You just have a brain freeze. It's what happens if you eat something cold too fast. It'll go away in a few seconds.
It will never go away. Oh, my brain. Make it stop. Hey. It's gone! No. You got me, word girl.
Thanks for helping me save the day, TJ. I couldn't have done it without you. Don't mind us. We're just waiting for the police to take this guy to jail. Just pretend we're not here. Invisible. Carry on.
Woo! Finally, here we go, once and for all. My dear wife, in honor of this very special occasion, I want to say to you...
Can I get that leftover ice cream to go, please?
No!
Oh, for the love of jelly beans! Here!
I love it!
I knew you would, because I know your heart, and it's good.
No! Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Forget the ice cream and race home to see those kids!
Yes! Aw. Uh-oh, we gotta get you home before they get home.
Huh?
TJ! Becky! We're home!
Oh, hey! You're back so early.
Becky, you look exhausted.
I'm fine. Babysitting. Phew, it can be a lot of work.
Where's TJ?
There you are, TJ. So, how was your first day with Becky as your babysitter?
Uneventful.
No. Yeah. Happy anniversary!
And so, yet again, Word Girl and Captain Huggy Face save the day. If you want to catch a glimpse of what it's like to be a superhero, be sure to tune in on another occasion for a delicious episode of Word Girl.
I'm Bo Handsome, and this is...
May I have a word?
As usual, the player who correctly defines today's featured word will win a fabulous prize. Let's play!
May I have a word?
Yes, you may. Today's featured word is bewilder. To give you a clue, here are some clips from Word Girl that show the meaning of the word. Shot, Tommy!
Bewilder means to transform from one person into another.
Nope! Have at it, Phil!
I thought I knew what bewilder meant, but now I'm completely confused. I'm totally puzzled!
You realize you just defined bewilder, right?
I did?
Yes! Bewilder means to puzzle or confuse!
Bewilder means to puzzle or confuse.
You just heard me say that.
I'm totally bewildered.
Why are you ringing in? I've already said the answer.
You have?
This is the most bewildering experience I've ever had. I'm going to declare that no one is today's winner. Huggy, show them what they would have won.
It's a go-kart. Wow, that would have been a fun prize.
That's it for today's episode. See you next time on...
May I Have a Word?
Listen for the words confiscate and whiz. When Dr. Two Brains wants a giant ray that turns objects into cheese, he usually makes it himself. And yet, here he is, shopping at Gadget Whiz Hal Hard Bargain's Villain Supply House. Why, you ask? Because even a supervillain can't resist the awesome power of a coupon.
Hello, I have a coupon. Says here I get a free piece of cheese with purchase of a super ray.
Yes, sirree, you do. I don't know how I stay in business handing out free cheese, but work isn't always about money, am I right? 5, 6, 7,
Well, thanks for the freebie.
Say, what do you plan to do with that ray that turns diamonds into cheese anyway?
We're gonna rob Reginald's jewelry store and turn all his diamonds into delicious cheesy goodness.
Ah, the jewelry store. I remember when the great villain Wally Walnuts robbed it.
Well, we should be going now.
It was me, Wally, Tommy Tunis,
well, we should be going
the
now.
Little kahuna, and Rotten Pete.
We really have to go.
Oh, well, what do I care? Let me know if you need another ray. Goodbye!
Later, outside City Hall, Word Girl is receiving the key to the city for the millionth time.
Word Girl, in honor of your efforts as a hero, role model, and crime-fighting whiz, we present you with this key to the city. Give key to Word Girl and pose for picture.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone. You know, when I first started fighting crime in this city, I made a promise to myself that I would always remain calm in the face of... Hey, what?
Please,
who did that?
Do not throw paper planes on the stage. If anyone throws a plane, I will have to confiscate it.
Dear Word Girl, Dr. Two Brains is going to rob Reginald's jewelry store. Yours truly. Wait, I forgot I'm not telling you who I am. Don't look up. Huh? Who is that guy? You're right. Sorry, Mayor. Gotta run. Word up!
Oh, jewels are better than people, and that's why they're my friends. I really don't like people, but I need them to buy my jewels. Ah, la, da, 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 dee, da, da.
Mind if I cut in?
Oh, dear.
We both know why I'm here.
Oh, it wouldn't be to rob me, would it?
Of course not. Of course not. Rob you? What? That's ridiculous. Rob you. This guy.
In that case, how may I help you, sir?
Yes, Dr. Two Brains, why are you here? With two henchmen and a giant ray.
I need a gift for my anniversary.
You're not married.
I meant my niece's graduation.
But, boss, she graduated 2 years ago. Lovely affair.
It's the anniversary of my niece's graduation, okay? Her graduation anniversary. Now let's escape. I mean, leave.
Not so fast, Dr. Two Brains.
Are you really going to arrest me for shopping?
Well, I guess you haven't actually committed a crime yet. I know, Huggy, but just because a paper plane says something doesn't mean it's true. I guess you can go. I'm confiscating this, whatever type of ray this is.
Great. See you later. So I just walked away from her, but she confiscated the ray before I really had a chance to use it, so maybe you'll consider giving me a new one for no charge. I'll tell you what, if you buy a new ray, I'll throw in another free piece of cheese. Eh? Sold. Perfecto. Thank you, Al. Now, since I know you don't like waiting, I'm going to suggest a ray that I just happen to have in stock. What does it do?
It turns money into cheese.
Wow. New plan, boys. We're gonna steal all the money out of the National Bank, then turn it into cheese, and then we're gonna eat the cheese.
That sounds like a great plan.
Gee, boss, if we're robbing a bank, why not just use the money to buy cheese?
Because I like to steal things that don't belong to me. It's part of being an evil villain. But wait, why not just steal the ray? I mean, it's what we do.
Whatever you say, boss.
Hey! Word Girl!
Sorry, Mr. Mayor. I had to go confiscate a weapon. Should I give my speech now?
Well, you flew away, so I changed this to a mayor appreciation party. Have a free snack in honor of His Honor the Mayor! Me!
Oh. Yeah, you're right. A party is a party. Let's eat. Thanks a lot. Hey, check this out. It says, turn around.
Word Girl, you don't have much time.
Time for what? And who are you?
That doesn't matter. Dr. Two Brains is going to rob the National Bank. If you hurry now, you can catch him and confiscate his ray.
But
go, go, go!
Okay!
It's really very simple. You give me all the money in the bank, or I will fire this ray that I just found sitting here. It isn't mine. Where did this come from? You should have Word Girl come pick it up. Oh, there she is. Have a nice day.
Word Girl, he pointed that ray at me and said, give me all the money in the bank.
Oh, he must have misheard me. I said to give me all the funny in the bank. I like that safe humor.
If I had known, I would have prepared something. No one tells me anything.
I don't need to be a whiz to figure out you're committing a crime here, Dr. Two Brains. But I can't figure out how. know, but I really want to get back to my party.
Yes, go enjoy yourself. You deserve it.
Okay, but I'm confiscating this ray.
You mean you're gonna eat it?
No, no, no. Confiscate means take away as a punishment. You guys were going to use this ray to commit a crime. And as a law-enforcing superhero, I have the power to confiscate it.
Oh, yeah. That makes sense.
Oh. I need another ray.
Great! I need some money because you stole the last one.
Very well. Here.
What can I get you?
I'm going after the dairy department of the grocery store, so this time I need a ray that turns cheese into more cheese.
Coming right up. Say, that reminds me. Did I ever tell you about the time Slow Feet Sam tried to rob a moving train?
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. You know, I just thought of something. How did Word Girl know about my crimes before they even happened?
She couldn't have, boss.
I smell a rat, and I should know. Someone's been tipping off Word Girl.
So, where did you say your next crime is gonna be?
The plans just changed, and I just found my rat.
Uh-oh.
You, Hal, are going to help me get Word Girl once and for all. And for that, I'm going to need a special order.
Meet me at the taco stand. Not again. Well, where is he?
No time for tacos, Word Girl. Dr. Two Brains is about to commit his biggest, cheesiest crime ever.
Tell me where the crime is and I'll go stop him.
Hi, Word Girl.
Hey. I mean, hey, those are mine. I confiscated them fair and square.
Make me some cheese, boys.
Oh, no. Activate plan number 396. Hey, over here. Can't get me.
Oh, yeah?
What do you say now, Dr. Two Brains? Dr. Two Brains?
Over here, Cheddar Girl. This ray turned superheroes into cheese. Hal, what happened?
I couldn't let you turn Word Girl into cheese. Hal Hardbuggin, villain supply whiz. I'm a big fan, Word Girl. You're the reason villains keep coming back to my store for new supplies.
That's why you told Word Girl about all of my plans? So she would confiscate my rays and I'd have to come back and buy more?
Hey, this guy's shop is Cheddar. I never said you could trust me. Just that I was a gadget whiz.
Your real name is Wiz?
No, he's saying he is a whiz. A whiz is someone who's really good at a certain skill. Like I'm a whiz at defining words.
Right, well, I'm glad everything worked out. I'm gonna head back now over to Hal Hardbargain's Villain Supply Store. We accept all competitors' coupons.
I don't think so, Hal. You may have told me about Two Brains' crimes, but you also helped commit those crimes by selling the ring.
Remind me to invent a monkey-proof jacket.
And so, Word Girl proves once again what a word whiz and crime-fighting whiz she is.
Say, I wonder if she has to confiscate that cheese or if I can take it home.
Join us next time on another fantastic, stupendous, cheesy episode of Word Girl.
Word Girl!
Hello, I'm Bo Handsome, and this is the bonus round of...
May I Have a Word?
Our returning champion will have a chance to play for even greater prizes on the bonus round.
Phil, you correctly defined the word bewilder, sort of. Ready to play the bonus round?
I guess.
Take a look at these three pictures and tell me which one shows the definition for bewilder. Give it to shock Phil.
I'm going to go with number...
3, right? In that picture, something has clearly confused Dr. Two Brains. He's bewildered.
Well, I'm not sure.
Oh, well, you are our bonus round winner. Show him what he's won, Huggy. An official Word Girl Hogo Stick. See you next time on...
Fighting crime with his kung fu punch and enormous appetite. For lots of monkey-filled fun, watch Word Girl on PBS Kids Go. Word up! Want more Word Girl? Watch your favorite episodes and test your word power on PBSKidsGo.org.
Want Word Girl's word power? Fly over to your local library. Cape not required. Word up!